Today it's going to be very interesting show and tell video, hopefully. At least it's very interesting for me. And it's about Ableton classic locks. So you can see a lot of locks and some kind of I call this Ableton classic training box kit, whatever you want to call it. And and I will explain why and why I build it and how I build it and what's the purpose of this one. So let's start. I will start with why. And this is not all my Ableton locks. That's the problem. I have maybe more of them, different versions, or sometimes a copy of them. So I have like 30, 56, 25, 2040, 2031, 2020. This is a Russian version of Ableton Classic Locks. The standard one, brass version of with brass shackle. This is 3020. This is the smaller version, the older one, a very small, the smallest one I think that they are making. This is a keychain. This is a Mauser lock. This is a cutaway lock. A fantastic design, and it's not my design. I saw it somewhere on some kind of a Norwegian or Finnish site. It's a very interesting. I will have a separate video for this one. Other cutaway and this big one. I already picked this one and I picked some of them too. And this I got it with a lot of locks and it was without key, so I made it a cutaway. Hopefully I will. I'm preparing a video with all of my cutaways lock, and I built this because I'm spending a lot of money on a different locks, different version of Ableton Classic. So I decided to make my own training Ableton Classic training box lock, and this is how it should look like. So I'll try to move everything left and right, and I will show you a close up how I did it and what is inside this box. So let me do a close up and let me show you how this should look like. So this is a cutaway for Ableton lock, so you can see that it's Ableton. I was thinking to cover it, but yeah, this is a bit better. And here is the inside, so you cannot drop anything. Before I continue with it, hopefully you already know that I designed this 3D printed pinning tray for Ableton Classic, and I designed this. I have a whole video how I designed this box to keeping my Ableton tool. And obviously, the obvious next step is to build my training box, or to build a training lock. So this how everything it fits. So you cannot, if this lock it's locked, you cannot drop anything. I mean, everything stays in their places. So what is in here? So let me move this here. So what do we have here? Spacers. Hopefully you can see this S 1 2 3 4 5 6, and again spacer. This is the regular spacers. I have like maybe 20 inside, I do not count, and then more than 10 discs. So 1 2 3 4 5 6, and some of them are with this cut, like for security part. Some of them, these are the regular ones. I have around 10 keys. You can fit more of them. I have one of the key, it's not cut, and this is for easily trying to figure it out. Cut your own key, or try to figure it out the number of the discs. And I have the here. I have the spacers. So because this is a training clock, you can use these spacers. I designed them, and it's a different. Like this is like different size. So now you can, like, this is how you remove one of them and try to pick. You remove a lot of them, and they are a different size. I'm not showing it properly. And yeah, and already inside there is a spacer, and here you can see I have the replacement part for covering. And let me first explain and show you how the lock works. So regular lock, but on this side, this is the key that it's working currently. on this lock. Come on. So you can just start unscrewing this one, and but first you need to unlock it. And here's how everything works. So let me just put it back, open it. Let me show you. And I did trade this with M20, so it's a very tricky way to trade this kind of locks, but successfully I did it. So here's how everything works. You put the key in, you insert the key in, you open, and then you can remove this and you can remove the whole core, and then that's how you can rebuild it or repin it. So maybe it's a good thing if I can rearrange things, show you, and maybe pick it if I have. So here's a pinning tray. Let me move the locks. So let me insert the key, unlock it. Oops. Sometimes because I have that the bigger, I think, so it's only four. Did I wait? Yeah, because it's sometimes it's catching, so you need to insert this key, and the last one you need to rotate it properly, and then you insert the key, you unlock, and then you can lock, doesn't matter. You need the key, you unscrew this part, put it somewhere, put the key here, and then you remove first is this plate, and then is the spring, and then you just drop everything. So here's how this looks inside. Let me put here. Here is the bar. Let me remove this one. Come on. And let me show you. This is the spacer. This is the longer spacer, I think. And I have the first disc that it's tensioning, and I have 1, 2, 3 discs, only two. And the last one, it's freely rotated. So if you put the key in, hopefully you can put the key in. And yeah, that's why I was trying previously to rotate the last one. Come on. Usually if you have all the discs inside, it's easy to, so I need to find the last one. Here it is. That's why this uncut key is very useful. So you put the key in, let me put all the way. And now when I start to rotate, hopefully you can see, the gates will align, and that's how you open the lock. So let me, I will try to pick this one. I did not try, to be honest, to pick. I just prepare it and I have it. So you put everything inside, and you have 10 replacements, or at least I have 10 replacements. So you need to go like this, putting everything inside. You can put more keys inside, and the keys here in Sweden, they're very expensive. Like one key to cut, you, if you want to cut a key, it's like 10 euros or 10 US dollars or more than $10. It's unbelievable how expensive they are. So you just put your key in, and now you need to unlock, unlock. Here is the inside, how it's, I dropped the key. So hopefully you can see that how you locked it, that moving part there. You lock it, unlock, unlock. So here's the lock, I locked the, so let me try to arrange properly, and I will try to pick, to be honest. Now I do like to pick this one if possible. I will try to pick it in my hand, maybe, maybe not. So you have the key, the right key, here's the lock, here's my pick. So let me rearrange. Hopefully I can pick it in my hand. Maybe. I'm not sure. I have never picked, or I don't remember that I picked disc lock in my hand. That's why. It's very tricky to do that. I'll try my best to use it like this. And let me rearrange my light. Focus there. And let's try to pick it. Usually I'm... Yeah, let me put all the discs. I forgot about that. I'm so excited about sharing my with you my... Come on. My new toy. Yeah, there it is. So where's my box? Let me rotate all the disc clockwise. And now let's insert the two. It's going to be very interesting how I'm going to hold everything together in my hand. But so try like this. Come on, there are three discs, so let me. So one, nothing, two, couple of clicks, three, binding. I think three, it's in a gate. So let me go up on the second one. Second one, it's fills in a gate, and the first disc. In a gate, it's very hard for me to hold it like this, but it's no, let me back up a bit. Fills in a gate, click, no, click, yes, and we're open. So that's how. Even it's it was very hard for me to hold it and pick it, but with three discs you can easily start learning. At least I'm pretty good at picking Ably classic locks, but for someone who is not that, this can be a interesting way of learning how to pick disc locks. So let me adjust all the disc, let me lock it up, and yeah, so this is, in my opinion, very cool thing to have, and I am pretty satisfied how I designed this, how I created. I spent a couple of days, to be honest, trying to design, but now I think I don't need hopefully I don't need any more Ably locks, and I found a supplier that it's I can buy this disc. They're a bit expensive, but doesn't matter. I mean, the locks are more expensive than this. Like, to get three of them, it's like around 150 to 200 euros. So, and this whole box is probably, I don't know how much money I spent to this, and I don't want to go into that, but it's my new training, Ably classic training lock. Sometimes I really like to just pick some lock, at least, especially these Ably classic locks. They have a very, they're very fun to pick because of the false gates that they have. I forgot to show them. So they have a really interesting false gates and really interesting feedback. And the feedback is sometimes it's very good, but sometimes it's like you don't know if you pick it, especially for the first and the last disc, because the rotation is pretty smaller than if you're in the middle, then the pick is going left and right pretty like 1 millimeter maybe. So yeah, This is my Abloy Classic training box, and this is my new toy. So I think this is all that I was pretending, or maybe more, to show you, and I didn't even pick the Abloy Classic lock. So guys, thanks for watching. I really appreciate if you stick, like, I don't know, 15 minutes now, or less than 15 minutes. So guys, really thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Have a nice picking, and bye bye.